your house. Where's your text at 9:30 and you're still out? Can't believe I'm still parked to you, waiting at your place.
We had been there a long time individually before we met, and we were kind of, long story short, we're kind of each of us coming to the end of a road in a sense, and it's really, really tough to make it in the music business. And I mean, it's hard to do any, like, chase your dreams anyway, but it's really hard to make it in the music business. And I was thinking about going home and trying to maybe do something else. I don't know what that would be. I'm not really good at anything else. But a mutual friend of ours introduced us, and we got together and wrote this next song, and it got us our record deal. So don't give up on what you're doing, you guys, because you just might get what you want. So the song's called I Can Make You Forget.
Yeah. I used to tour a little bit with Pure Prairie League. They asked me to come up and sing with them in Akron at this venue when I was 15. So my mom and I drove. Was anybody here? That was like 10 plus years ago. But it's really cool to be back and be like, oh my gosh, wow. Little 15-year-old, didn't know what was coming. But how amazing are these ladies?
Yeah.
So fun to get to hang all girls now. This might be my first one, actually.
Yeah, years?
Really?
Yeah, it's awesome. So, like Danielle, I'm about to put out my album, and it's my debut album, which is crazy, on October 13th. So I'm going to play you guys a bunch of songs up there, too. I don't know if any of the ladies can relate, but has anybody ever dated a guy who is particularly good at kind of sucking? It might be my table. I feel like that's why you were sucking on him. Well, I hope that you're not here with me tonight.
No!
You've got your beer, you're like, oh. I like to write songs with my good girlfriends at night while we drink wine. And oh, this one has one of those. This is called Doing It Right. Some shitty little motel, you check in and you check out like hell. Well, in case you couldn't tell, oh, I ain't your old guitar that you leave out in the back of your car that you never play. Oh, but you say that you're gonna play. And if you wanna burn us to the ground, make sure that I never come back around. You're doing it right. A lot of depressing songs. And I mean, not songs that's gonna make you like, oh wow, I feel horrible, but just I hope the songs I've been writing are more, oh, I can relate. And like I said, I didn't write my first record. It's more of a listening and picking type of process. I was on this TV show called The Voice. And that was about 5 years ago, which is crazy. I was 16 years old and now I'm 21. And you learn a lot about yourself, big time, especially at 16, you do not know who you are. I personally had
no idea. I was like, oh my God, this is craziness. Right off the show, it was just, I mean, make an album, go on tour, everything just like back to back to back. And I was just like, okay, so these past 4 years are more of, okay, I'm gonna stick it in Nashville, I'm gonna start songwriting and see if I like it and see if I'm actually good at it. That's one thing. And I've been co-writing a lot. I haven't written a song by myself just yet, hopefully, maybe third record. I got into a mood where I was like, you know what, I'm gonna write but nothing but just real songs about real situations that are happening to me. Me and my boyfriend were going through some relationship problems, and I'll be honest with y'all, we were. And it was perfect timing of making my second album. So I wrote about it. And it was more of like, oh, not of like the I hate yous, it was more of, I would be so terrified if this happened because I love him and I don't want to lose him. And just about funny memories or just about a current feeling. And this next song was one where I got in a room with another girl writer and we just talked about life and more about not trying not to lose yourself and just craziness. And so we wrote this song that I just wanted to really keep for the album, and it's called Layin' Low. I hope you like it.
With some of our dear friends, Justin Lance and Billy Montana, and And she wrote this with her grandfather in mind, who is John Wayne, the actor. Yeah! So this song is kind of for, you know, women out there looking for their ultimate cowboy. And don't look for John Wayne, because he's gone. There's people, there's no one left like that.
That's why I'm single.
But anyway, you guys, this is Wild West. We're really excited to finally have this as our single. It's been a long time coming for this. So.
And Sue, I don't know where you are, but thank you so... There you are. Thank you so much for adding this song yesterday. And y'all, Sue over here, she takes a chance on new music and new artists, and that's why we're all up here. And thank you so much for playing all three of us.
Story or anything about me. I love the late 90s and early 2000s women like Trisha and Faith and Sarah Evans and Shania.
Allison Krause. I grew up just loving that kind of country music, yes, and bluegrass. And when I was writing songs for the album, I wanted to make sure to have some of those just like vocal moments that you maybe would think of when you just think of those ladies when you listen to them. And I don't know if anybody's ever felt second best, but this is kind of what that song is about. This is called If My Name Was Whiskey.
First thing on your mind every time. And if I wasn't where you thought I'd be, you'd drive around till you found me. If it took all night, and you'd press me to your lips, say you never felt like this, and I'd be all night, and you'd get drunk on me.
Because when I did it at first, I was really young. I was about 17, 18. And I feel like I got lucky to do it a second time because I just wanted to reintroduce myself to everybody. And I knew there's a lot more I wanted to say. And I wanted to grow up a little more. And so thank you, Radio, for giving me that second chance. And so this song, I actually did the music video for it not too long ago, and so we're figuring out when it's gonna be released, so I'm excited about that. And I got in a writing room one day, just a scheduled write, and they asked me what I needed. I'm in the middle of making my second record, what am I missing? I wrote this song about 2 years ago, which is crazy. And they asked me, and I was like, you know, I don't have that laid back, kind of feel freely, like crowd participation song. I've never had one of those. And they're like, okay, they're on board immediately. And I was like, and I don't want to think about the lyrics too much because we'll get kind of off guard and we'll get bored and it's just going to be way too long. And they're like, okay, we got it. And I was like, cool. And so we ended up writing my newest single, and it's called Sway. Hey, we're all in the same boat. Life can really suck sometimes. But hey, can't live in a shadow. So here's a little piece of
lonely. She wasn't once upon a time.
She used to dance when the band played. She used to be the trusting kind. She's no stranger to the leaving. She's heard all the best goodbyes.
But I feel like if you need to know anything about me, it's that I love red wine.
Yeah.
Oh shoot, he knows what's coming. Do the thing. Yeah, do the thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Fine.
And sometimes, Akron, you make decisions that are questionable. While under the influence. Red wine, hi. I know. I feel like we're connected now. Great. And an ex-boyfriend is around. We're gonna get funky. It's called Hide the Wine. You'll understand the thing, and if you guys want to join in, I like crowd participation.
Well, I heard that you were back here. in town. Well, it's been a hot minute since me and you were hanging out.
Oh.
Yeah, we had that crazy kind of chemistry. Where you give barn, don't care, just reach for another match of gasoline. Well,
goofball. If y'all probably see, follow him on social media. Oh my gosh,
he's really cute too.
And Thomas Shrett is just goals with his family. Oh my gosh. But I got to bring writers out one weekend. Emily Wiseband and Sam Ellis, and they're two amazing writers and just amazing people overall. Emily has become like one of my best friends, so she's been on this next record a bunch, because I feel comfortable telling her a lot of stories and then we write about it. And so I got to bring them out to hang out, write songs, and for them to see the show, which was awesome. And one day Thomas Shrett knocked on the door of the bus and he was like, "Do y'all mind if I kind of crash your ride?" I'm like, are you kidding me? Oh my gosh. And I haven't written with other artists much at all. And so I thought that was really cool. I'm like, oh my gosh, and Thomas Shrett is Thomas Shrett and he's so talented.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so he came on the bus and he had this awesome idea that we all kind of, hands are flying everywhere. That we kind of all chimed in and we're like, oh, well, yeah, we've been there, done that, or I could see us going there. And so we continued to write it and we had so much fun and ended up keeping it for the record. And it's called What Are We Doing?
That everybody gets funded to have a free mammogram, right? Is that what it is? That's awesome. So thank you so much for being here. It was such a great cause.
That's an important one too.
It is. Yeah.
So many ages are showing up with that horrible disease, and we're happy to do anything that we can. We thank you guys for coming out for this. This is our very first single to go to country radio. Our team told us we are the first female trio in over a decade to have a top 25 song in country radio. So, it's absolutely too long. And absolutely amazing that we get to be a part of country music in such an exciting time. And thank you. Thank you, WMCQ, for playing the song and supporting us.
What did I say? Wait,
WMCQ?
You just put four letters together.
I'm saying telegrams, and you're saying wrong.
It's kind of like when you walk into a room like you're on the list, and you're like, I'm just going to put letters together.
All right, you guys, this is lipstick.
You know what would be really helpful just in the future is if you put it really big on the poster behind us. And then maybe we could just know. Just for you guys. Alright, here's lipstick.
Pearce comes from my grandparents, and the feather on my arm, the feather in my logo, just everything about me. My album is dedicated to my grandparents. I'm an only grandchild, and they both passed on from cancer. And they were such a huge part of my life, and always knew I was going to move to Nashville and chase this dream. And this next song, I'm originally from Northern Kentucky, so not too far. And when I was 16, I saw an audition for singers in the country show at Dollywood. Oh. And convinced my dad to let me quit high school and homeschool because I wanted to chase my dreams.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah. Good girl.
Think about that, Dad. And looking back, I think that everybody can relate no matter where you come from. When you are a teenager, you want to get as far away from your parents
far away from your hometown as you can. And that was definitely me. I could not wait to get out of Taylorville, Kentucky. And 10 years later, give or take, looking back, I have such an appreciation for where I come from and would give anything. My favorite thing to do with my grandpa was sit at his kitchen table, and that was where he always found him. And I would give anything to be able to go back and do that one more time, and I think I appreciate everything a little bit more and wish I could go tell 16-year-old Carly to soak it in a little more. So please insert your own hometown into this. This is called I Need a Ride Home.
Yes! Woo!
Especially to be here to help what we're here for. Since we're kind of sharing things, my aunt actually passed away last week from cancer.
Sorry. It's been really hard. This is the first time I've cried on stage. thank you for coming and for being all together. And I'll try to sing this next song, but
my album will be out December 1st. this last song is one of my favorites I got to be a part of writing, and it's called Worth It. I hope you like it.
Don't tell me I'm too hard to please. That you're worn down from fighting for me. And if you don't, then I'll show myself the door. Cause I'm worth it. You crazy baby if you think that I don't know it. I ain't afraid to walk away if you can't see it. Believe it and give me the love I'm deserving. Is it too much to look me in the eye and listen to what I'm saying this time? I'm so tired of being up on your shelf. And if that's what you want, you want somebody else. Cause I'm worth it. You crazy baby.
So we're all just really proud to be here, and this last song is, I guess, kind of for anybody that's lost anybody, really. This is one of our favorite songs we've ever been a part of, and this last year we got to play at the Grand Ole Opry for the first time, which is a lifelong dream for any country singer, any singer, really. And we always knew that if we did ever get the invite, we wanted to play this song because it was so special to us. So now it's just double extra special to us.
This song's called Blue Roses.
It's food for the flowers. It's the lonesome sound. Now how do I get through when even wild roses are blue in my dreams? You reach out for me in my dreams. I reach out for you.
Thank you again. Just this year has been really crazy for me. I've been in Nashville for 8 years and trying to make this thing happen, and wrote this song about a real relationship and a guy that really devastated me and just the battle that I went through. I know it's woo now, it wasn't all at the time.
Not at all.
It's really hard. I'm sure so many of you have either been through heartbreak or know somebody who has, and it's devastating and a roller coaster ride. And never in a million years did I think that this little song about my story of trying to get over him would do what it's done. And I am so thankful to Sue and to Country Radio, just for, from the bottom of my heart, all of you. Like, this is my dream, and this little song is sitting at number 7 on the Billboard. Yeah. So to anybody who's requested it or turned it up on the radio, or, I don't know, cried, I cried with you, it's fine. Just thank you guys, and I will be back in November with Brett Young. Losing people, but truly, thank you guys, and thank you for being awesome, and again, thank you for having us too. This is
shine the same.
They say time is the only healer. Well, God, I hope that isn't right, 'cause right now I die to die to remember every little thing. I remember every little thing that I heard Sean say. Every little thing. Oh, I remember every little thing. And I'm haunted by the memories of every little thing that I heard Sean say.